Only two laps to go for Kyle Busch in the lead.
He's taking advantage of those tires just like Ankrum is. We haven't seen these guys running that far up toward the front all night long, but great strategy by their crew chiefs. They've got them in great positions here to get a good finish. You want to try to go back to back top five, fourth last time out in Atlanta. One lap remaining at Homestead Miami. Now Busch in command. Busch leads by over 2 seconds, but it's a great battle for position throughout the pack. Kyle now on the backstretch. Ankrum second, Chastain, Sauter, and now Elliott up to the fifth spot. Kyle Busch started at the rear of the...
Ready to go, Wowdy Busch.
Since 2013, and that was in 2017.
Amazing. Wins here at Homestead Miami Speedway in the trucks for the
third time. Still on freeze.
Also won a couple of times in the Xfinity Series. Got a couple of truck or a couple of cup wins and championship victories here at Homestead. And he'll try to get another one of those cup victories tomorrow. But right now, he climbs out as team owner and race winner. He talked about our hard-working Fox team. There they are, Vince. They're going to make it a great...
He was taking the bow. Take it a bow
to the speedway to watch, and we'll be anxious to see them and honor them in that way by allowing them to come and watch the racing.
And then some 5,000 fans and some campers are going to be allowed to attend Talladega. So NASCAR hit it out of the park by getting NASCAR back live sports racing, and now we're inviting fans out. I'm so proud of being a part of this sport.
Matt's with the winner.
Well, Kyle Busch put on such a show tonight. Really showed your presence with authority there on those two restarts, especially the last one. You were three wide down in turns one and two. How concerned were you with the sticker tires that were just a couple rows behind you?
I mean, you're always concerned about tires being better and having the opportunity to outshow you, but felt like six laps was just the right amount, you know, and any more than that, it probably would have been a different outcome. But can't say enough about this Cessna Beechcraft Toyota Tundra. It was awesome tonight. I mean, it's been awesome all year. We've just had some fluke things that have kind of taken us out of the running. But, you know, the last restart there with Ross behind me, he got a good launch, and I got a good shove from him down the front stretch, and then there was room to the middle for him. Obviously, here we go, and I had to get room, you know. We just tried to race it out on the outside and see what happens off of turn two here. Just able to get that momentum around the outside. I didn't lift much through the corner, and just got that run, and then those guys stuck side by side, was just able to let me get away. So, you know, really good race for us, and proud of everybody at KBM, proud of the effort. I know we've got issues, and we'll continue to work on that and get better.
Well, you mentioned the issues. You had a little hiccup in inspection. You started...
We'll see this. We'll see you tomorrow at 3:30 p.m. on Fox at Homestead Miami Speedway for tomorrow on Fox.
I mean, we've thrown away the last two races. I mean, this is how we're supposed to perform and run and look. And the deal with the infraction was a fluke deal. That's how these trucks were allowed to run last time down here at Homestead. And this thing's just been sitting on the side waiting for me to get back behind the wheel, or get behind the wheel of it. And it didn't go to the fab shop, so it didn't get a bar cut out that was was legal here last year and not legal here this year. So not sure there was a performance advantage to it, but just something that we've been running and not allowed to do it anymore.
But the fun meter definitely was pegged. Two wins and a second this year for Kyle Busch.
And his teammates, Christian Eckes, finishes eighth, and Rafael Lazard finishes.